Imagine a sound so loud, it literally ruptures the eardrums of people 40 miles away. A sound that circled the Earth 4 times. In 1883, humanity heard the apocalypse. This is the story of Krakatoa. The Sunda Strait, Dutch East Indies, one of the busiest shipping lanes in the world. In the middle of it stood Krakatoa, a lush, green, volcanic island. It had been dormant for over 200 years. To sailors, it was a familiar landmark. No one suspected they were living next to the most powerful explosive device on the planet. It began in May 1883. The Earth trembled. Smoke and ash began to rise from the crater of Krakatoa. The seismic activity was felt as far away as Batavia, 100 miles from the volcano. But in a region full of active volcanoes, this didn't cause alarm. Instead, it caused curiosity. Dutch colonists organized excursions to the volcano to watch the fireworks. They applauded as it spat fire into the night sky. This was a fatal mistake. They didn't realize that the magma chamber beneath the island was rapidly filling. The pressure was reaching a critical point. The mountain was preparing to self-destruct. The atmosphere became electric. Compasses spun wildly, and eerie St. Elmo's fire danced on the rigging of ships. August 26th, noon. Krakatoa's patience ran out. The first catastrophic explosion occurred. The volcano launched a plume of ash 17 miles into the stratosphere. Day turned to night. Ships in the strait were pelted with hot stones and searing mud. The roar became continuous. Captain Watson of the British ship Charles Ball recorded, "It is a dreadful night, a blinding fall, pitch darkness around us, broken only by the continuous flashes of lightning." Others described it as sailing into hell. The first tsunamis followed, caused by the partial collapse of the volcano. But this was only the prelude. The real horror was set to unfold at dawn. The morning of August 27th. Over 4 hours, Krakatoa annihilated itself in a series of 4 colossal explosions. The volcano walls collapsed, and billions of gallons of seawater rushed into the empty magma chamber. The contact of water with lava triggered a steam explosion of unimaginable force. The final blast at 10:02 a.m. Its power is estimated at 200 megatons of TNT, 10,000 times more powerful than the bomb dropped on Hiroshima. 2/3 of the island of Krakatoa simply vanished. The blast generated pyroclastic flows, superheated hurricanes of gas and ash that raced directly across the surface of the ocean, incinerating everything in their path. But Krakatoa's deadliest weapon was the mega tsunamis. The mountain's collapse generated waves up to 130 feet high, taller than a 12-story building. They crashed onto the shores of Java and Sumatra, wiping entire cities off the map. 36,000 people died almost instantly. When the dust settled, the world had changed. Where Krakatoa once stood, there was only open ocean. The Sunda Strait was choked with debris, pumice, and bodies. The steamship Barao was found nearly 2 miles inland, thrown into the jungle by the tsunami. But Krakatoa's impact was felt across the planet. Millions of tons of sulfur dioxide were ejected into the atmosphere, causing a volcanic winter. Global temperatures dropped. For 3 years, sunsets around the world were blood red. It is believed that these apocalyptic skies inspired Edvard Munch to create his famous painting, The Scream. Krakatoa also became the first global catastrophe known almost instantly, thanks to underwater telegraph cables. The volcano didn't die. In 1927, a new volcano emerged from the water, Anak Krakatau, the child of Krakatoa. It is growing rapidly and remains lethally dangerous. What struck you the most about this story? Let us know in the comments and subscribe to Past Forward for more stories that shaped our world.